Back here at the Coliseum, it is just about that time. The Islanders and the Rangers facing off here in Uniondale for the first time this season. Closed captioning is brought to you by the New York Lottery. Hey, you never know. The fans itching for this game to start, so let's get to it. Butch and Howie, take it away.
Boy, are they ever, Shannon. I don't know if it was just a couple of days of cabin fever or all the frustrations of the last couple of days just trying to get from point A to point B. But these fans, and there are large factions representing both sides, have been going at it verbally since before the national anthem. So this could be interesting.
I think this is going to be really neat, Howie, because you're right. The Islander fans have been waiting for this game for a long time. Their team is in first place. They're all ready to give it their all. And there's plenty of Ranger fans, so it could be a little testy at times.
And by the way, I think everybody who made it here tonight really owes, and this has nothing to do with your political leanings or anything specific, but I think a lot of credit has to go to Governor Cuomo, who issued that edict last night. Get off the roads by 11 o'clock. They were in surprisingly good shape, so I think most people were able to get here without too much difficulty. And so, we are set to begin.
Agreed, Howie.
Nick Leddy immediately hit by Dan Girardi. Leddy dumped as the Islanders play it into the Rangers zone. McDonough avoids a hit. Franz Nielsen got the worst of it. And the puck sent deep. Already a linesman has taken a spill. Tim Noack fell over at the far side. As the crowd goes into their taste great, less filling routine. Ranger and Islander fans exchanging plaudits. As Boychuk plays it in the Islanders' zone, ahead now to Lee. Let's go and drive. Lundqvist saves. Grabowski working behind the net. Mikhail Grabowski put it in front. Missed by Tavares. Hamonic a drive. That hit a leg. And Nash springs Zuccarello. He couldn't hold it, though. And Nash regains the puck. Starting lineups brought to you by Infinity, luxury cars that deliver inspired performance.
When John Tavares scored 4 goals in the All-Star game, and he almost got one on his very first shift. And that pass from Grabowski just wasn't able to follow the puck all the way to his stick in front of the net.
Now Tavares at the far side as Jesper Fast missed a hit in the corner. Hamonic hit there by Hadlin. And now Tavares flings one rink wide looking for DeHaan. Dan Boyle chipped it back the other way. Rangers move it in, but Hayes loses on a stick check by Bailey. Islanders to the Ranger line, but no further. And the puck right by the red line is dumped into the Ranger zone. Picked off by Grabner. And a save made by Lundqvist. Bouncing puck slithers loose. And is brought along now by Fosht. And sent back in by Hickey for the Islanders.
The one thing about Lundqvist against the Islanders, he's either been very good or just very average. That was a big save for him early in this period.
Kevin Klein throws one towards the net. Luck got a piece of it. Brian Strake pulls up, takes a bump. Lubomir Vyshnovsky remains out of the lineup for the Islanders, along with Kyle Oposo. And now Martin to the corner in the Rangers zone. He's lined up by Boyle. They bump. Martin along the goal line now. Swings it to the front of the net, which was well covered by Dominic Moore for the Rangers. Now to Boyle, number 22. Cizikas finished a hit on him. And the Islanders have it again. Martin to Clutterbuck. The fourth line out for the Islanders, and Butch has been saying for the last month or so, best fourth line in hockey based on their production and all of the work they do physically that changes the game's tempo so often.
Well, they had a big part in the outcome against the Flyers game, Howie, if you recall how physical they got once the Flyers tried to take advantage of them a little bit.
A little bouncer sent in by Strome gave Lundqvist some trouble. One hit by Lee, that was on Girardi. A second against Kreider. Lee and Girardi turn each other around, and McDonough, the Ranger captain, outlets to Derek Stepan, number 21. Now to Kreider. Chris Kreider winds it in behind the Islander goal.
And one of the areas the Islanders will have to be very careful is a couple of Rangers are real breakaway specialists. Kreider, Hagelin have great speed. You have to keep your eye on them when they're on the ice.
Rangers chip it into the Islander end. Nash gets there, bumps with Hamonic, sent to the slot. Klein doesn't get much on it, but it's kept alive by Zuccarello. DeHaan had his arm draped around Brassard, number 16. Derek Brassard, a hard feed to Staal, and it's knocked down by Hamonic in front. Worked around, kept by Klein, and then the bouncing puck brought along by Hamonic. And out come the Islanders. Grabowski in over the Ranger line to Tavares. A move on Stalin and Dandy. He centers for Grabowski. That's knocked away. And Brassard moves the other way. Fired it off the skate of Hamonen. John Tavares. And a pretty nice move there that nearly created an ideal scoring chance.
Well, just got back from the All-Star game, and that was a game of skills, pretty much. So John Tavares put a little his skill on display there.
Rather a farcical event as games go, but for goal scorers, it was a bonanza. 29 goals in a hockey game. Or something like a hockey game.
Checking or getting in front of the puck was definitely more than optional. It was an absolute necessary to get out of the way.
Well, puck flips over the glass at Adam's play, so nearly continuous play over the first 4.5 minutes.
Well, the Islanders have certainly taken advantage of a couple of miscues. There's a bad pass by Klein. Good save on Grabner by Lundqvist. Watch the puck come in between the feet of John Tavares. A little backward move and get it out to the front of the net and see what happens out there. Grabowski had an opportunity. Bailey was there, but John Tavares, whether the game means the world to him at this point in time or just a little walk in the park, he's still going to do the same things. He's a gifted individual, and this is a big game. Still as smooth as silk out there.
Speaking of the All-Star game, they combined the number of hits for both teams. Nash lines up a shot. Kick save. Good one made by Halak. No hits were credited in the All-Star game. Literally a no-hitter.
You don't see that very often in the game of hockey. What a save that was. Aggressive save on Nash by Halak. So in spite of giving up a couple of goals in the All-Star game, he still maintains his solid play.
Boyle slams it off the boards. Recovered by the Islanders' Brock Nelson for DeHaan. Rangers 4 shots, the Islanders 3 over the first 5 minutes. No icing here. Lundqvist goes to the trapezoid.
I asked Halak about the All-Star game. Did he feel like he was tired at all? Did he need enough? Did he get enough rest?
Looked like a little indecision about whether Halak wanted to gather that in or connect with the defenseman.
Every time he gets the puck, it's a little bit of an adventure when he handles it. But he said, no, he feels really good. Really, there wasn't that much going on. So he feels ready and refreshed and ready to continue on this season.
JT Miller, number 10, doesn't connect with Stahl. Martin will challenge. He's covering some territory, lining up Klein. Good hit in the corner on Klein. They hold each other off. Klein got it loose. Covered by Nielsen until Kreider steps into him.
That's one of the toughest plays in hockey is when you're going back as a defenseman to pick up the puck and you got a big hitter coming down on your hard. Now you try and protect yourself and the puck at the same time. That's a tough play in hockey.
Every once in a while you'll see a player just kind of turn those skates as if to say, I'm vacating.
And I'm bailing just a hair.
You're straight. Looking for a lead, batted away. Step on. Got it out of the zone, and now Hickey for the Islanders.
Very quick pace out here for both teams. The Islanders seem to have just a little bit more jump, but it's maybe home ice adrenaline.
Yeah, and all I'm seeing right now are scattered, empty seats. I mean, every seat is not nearly filled. But a chance for Hickey, and a save by Lundqvist. There are plenty of people, and they're plenty loud.
They're into it, and there's still people filing in. But it's been a good start for the Islanders. 28 goal scorer Rick Nash and then Thomas Hickey both having opportunities to score early in this game. Rick Nash, good position, good aggressive save by Halak. Look, he's outside the top of the crease. And then a nice play by Ryan Stromont to Thomas Hickey. Thomas Hickey forces the turnover by pinching in. Stromer jumps on the loose puck and Thomas Hickey gets himself in a good position. Lundqvist has had to be good early, Howie. A couple of real good saves.
Tavares wins a draw. Bailey a drive and a save by Lundqvist. Tavares digs it out. Stepan chasing. Tavares turns, swings it to the front of the net where it's batted away. McDonough throws one ahead for Stepan. He was tangled up with Tavares. Brought in by St. Louis. Works on Boychuk. Marty St. Louis looks for some space. Finds Girardi, but he didn't hold it. And the Islanders come to center. Grabowski in over the line. Now Lenny steps up, shoots Lundqvist, the save, he'll hold. With 7:08 gone here in the first period, you could win Islanders tickets and a team-side hockey stick in the WDAB Islanders Watch and Win sweepstakes. Listen to Roger and JP on WDAB 102.3 tomorrow morning at 9:20. Remember the WDAB player to watch, it's John Tavares. to call in for your chance to win.
Well, I'll tell you what, Howie, you have to like the way the Islander defense are getting involved in the play. They're not sitting back waiting on the Rangers. They're jumping up on the play and looking for opportunities. And the Islanders are creating time and space, so it's tough plays for the Rangers right now in the defensive zone.
And both teams have come out attempting to take the body, as is done right there at the far side by Tanner Glass on Kuhlman. Another hit that puts Glass down. That was a return engagement type hit delivered by Nikolai Kuhlman, coming off a two-goal game against Philadelphia in the last game the Islanders played a week and a day ago.
The leading hitter on the Rangers is Girardi, and you would expect the defenseman to have more opportunities. But for the Islanders, it's Matt Martin and Clutterbuck who lead their team.
And already, Butch, 16 hits recorded the first 8 minutes, eight hits by each team.
Now both teams respecting each other's speed. The way you slow the speed down is to try and hit them, wear them down. It's probably a strategy for both New York teams.
Bosch doesn't clear. Good job by Cizikas. Yeah, Clutterbuck going to the front of the net. Sets up DeHaan. Winds it around. Grabbed by Cizikas, but chipped away by Hunwick. That's Matt Hunwick, number 44. And now Boyle behind the Ranger goal. Shots are 6-5 Islanders early on. DeHaan up the middle. A little chip feed from Cizikas to Clutterbuck. Now to Martin. It handcuffed Lundqvist, but he stopped it. DeHaan wrists one off the skates of Fosh. And is played out of the zone.
Islanders certainly have a shoot first mentality, not overpassing. Always a good thing.
Anders Lee takes the long pass onside. Shoved by McDonough. Pair of 27s. They keep working. Sent to the corner for Brassard. It's hemmed in by Ryan Strome. Lee wins the puck. Anders Lee again draws the attention of McDonough and connects. Does McDonough with Brassard. Rangers don't clear. That shot shanked by Lee. Islanders get it again. Letty to Boychuk. At that big shot, drives a hard pass through the slot. That's recovered by Brassard of the Rangers.
Islanders have really been on their toes, not allowing the Rangers to get anything going coming out of their zone. Terrific forechecking, good pinching.
Brassard to Stahl, wrist shot blocked. And Strome looks for an outlet. The shot hit Boychuk, who was slow to get up. And he's hobbling as he makes his way to the Islander bench. Meantime, Tavares pulls up, centers Grabowski. He shot it wide. Maybe Lundqvist got a piece. Islanders keep it. Hickey wrists one. Save made. Rebound Tavares over the net. And step on for the Rangers. Off the glass, all the way down. Short of the goal line. Icing waved off. Oh, Hickey pulled down, but yeah, nothing called.
Yeah, lucky for Kreider. Should have definitely been a trip.
And now straight pushes one ahead to Bailey. On to Tavares. Couldn't hold it long enough to put a move on Hunwick. But Tavares gets to it in the corner with Grabowski. It's a two-on-two there. JT emerging with it. Spinning on Stepan. Tavares got it towards the side of the net anyway. Comes back now to Bailey. He couldn't tee it up. And out come the Rangers. Three-on-two developing. Bailey evens it up. Kreider in. Kreider shoots. He went wide. Big carom comes to Hunwick. Bothered by Grabowski, and out come the Islanders. Bailey cuts through the middle, in over the line. A drop pass to Hamonic joining in. In front of went off Lundqvist's stick. Comes back to DeHaan. Now to Nelson to the slot. Three Rangers come to Brock Nelson. And it's JT Miller emerging with a puck. 9 minutes remaining.
Now fans are really appreciative of the effort the Islanders have put forth in these first 10 minutes. I don't think I've ever seen Tavares as sharp as he's been in this first period. I mean, he is really on the bit.
He has challenged the Ranger defense consistently.
Oh, and with great speed.
There's Klein firing. It's blocked. Comes back behind the net. Boychuk there. He's okay after being drilled on his last shift. And now Brock Nelson looking to dump it in. Does. The Islanders will change on the move.
Islanders out shooting the Rangers 10-5 and a half a dozen real good opportunities, not just shots at the net, quality attempts.
And a spirited, fast-moving first period. It's
Boy,
been fun.
It is. Yeah, it is. I thought it might take these guys a period to get going, but no, they've come out of the gate running.
Wonder how much of that is just the sight of each other.
The sight and the fans and the adrenaline.
There's Cizikas. Let's go and drive. That hits a stick. And ricochets out of play. Exactly 8 minutes remaining in the opening period. A lot of hits, but no goals. Well, tonight's Geico hometown hero is specialist Stephen Lear Jr. from Poughkeepsie, New York. Stephen served 2.5 years of service to the U.S. Marine Corps as a crash fire rescue specialist and is currently in the New York Army National Guard. We appreciate the commitment and the support of Stephen Lear Jr. and the entire military.
Yeah, I love the fact he's wearing that Islander jersey too, Howie.
Sitting with three who are not. He was the one smiling and standing.
And the rest of the Islander fans at the Coliseum hope they're in the same happy mood. And this one ends. But we're scoreless. 7:49 to go in the first period. Line, he gave it away. Martin, a shot. Lundqvist looking, but he's got it. And holds on. Not even sure if he knows exactly where it is yet.
Now we talk about the fourth line. I actually talked to Clutterbuck this morning about the fourth line. He said, well, I don't know if we're really a fourth line. We're all pretty decent players. But look at the good hard work by Cizikas. First the forecheck, then the reach out. Matt Martin circles back in and out. Tries to go five hole on Lundqvist. And anytime the goaltender turns his head and looks to see where that puck is, you know he got a little bit lucky, but a great job of forechecking by Casey Cizikas. I'm calling him now the MC square line, Howie, because E equals MC squared. Energy, Martin, Cizikas, Clutterbuck. MC square line. What do you think?
All right, who gave that to you?
Nobody. I'm a little more well-versed than people give me credit.
Yep. You just convinced me. So, you've got your Einstein theory of relativity, and you've got your Goering theory of fourth lines. Add it up, same thing. Shot from the blue line block. You know, I'm not convinced, by the way. Grabowski holds it along the near boards. I say you had an accomplice.
No, I would not lie about such things.
You had a wonderful week, didn't you?
I had too much time on my hands.
Islanders have iced it with 7 minutes to go in the period. Well, here are our cold, hard facts. Theories of relativity be darned. Brought to you by Coors Light. Well, for the Islanders, three is the magic number, and conversely for the Rangers, it's two. We'll see which might emerge as the more significant number by the end of the night.
Yeah, if Islanders score three, I guess that means they win.
Chance in front off a redirection by St. Louis, knocked aside. And the Rangers get it back. Boyle backs up to the Ranger blue line. Dan Boyle had a sluggish start to the season, injury, illness. But he's back in shape now. Gets a feed from St. Louis, shoots, blocked the save. Stepan gets it. Centers, and a save made by Halak on Stahl, who was loose for a good hard low one-timer.
Well, that was a great save by Halak. Good push by the Rangers. Stepan had an opportunity, but watch on this faceoff. Watch St. Louis come all the way around over there. Then you're going to see him get in the open and a quick little pass. Terrific play by the Rangers, and they use that offensive faceoff really to continue to put pressure on the Rangers. And what a glorious opportunity for Stahl. Couldn't be in a better position right in the slot area. Couldn't hit the corner.
And from the draw, the Islanders still back in their own zone. DeHaan takes a hit from Brassard. And Hamonic one from Zuccarello. But up comes Nielsen. Nice feed to DeHaan. Let's go, a drive and a save by Lundqvist. A sizzler by Calvin DeHaan.
Once again, the Islander defense jumps up into the play to create an odd man rush. Starts with a good speed of Franz Nielsen coming out of the own zone. Number 51 makes a pass to DeHaan, who jumps up in the play. So the Islanders continue to be very, very aggressive. Kevin Wano talks about this all the time. Wants his defense involved in the offense. DeHaan, a very good skater, reads the play. And nice play from Franz Nielsen through the neutral zone.
So 6:13 remain in the period. Islanders have outshot the Rangers 12-9. And it looks like Kevin Hayes has been thrown out of the draw. It'll be taken instead by Jesper Foss. Wins it back to McDonough. Ryan McDonough, off pass ahead, batted away. McDonough lost the handle. Here's Nelson with Grabner. Nelson shooting, save made. Grabner the rebound, swings it to the net. Blocked aside by Lundqvist. comes back out to the front. Ost has it. After a quick exchange with Hayes, they move to center for a Hayes dump in. Poked at by Halak. Ultimately to the corner where Nelson just shoves it up the boards and back into the Ranger end of the ice. 5:40 to go first period. Quick change by the Islanders. Rangers move it in quickly. Hayes in the corner. Just shoved down nicely by Letty. And the Rangers get the puck back. Miller feeds the blue line. Stahl plays it around the boards. Haglund against Boychuk. Haglund to Miller. And a sharp angle shot is held by Halak. 5:19 remaining, first period of a scoreless game.
Welcome back to Nassau Coliseum. Here in the first period, no score between the Islanders and the Rangers, but the fans here are all hyped up, and I have a feeling that there might be a score from an Islanders player coming up sometime before the end of the period. I'm predicting it. If they do score, I'll be talking with them. If they don't, I'll still have an Islanders player. And also, John Tavares coming off a four-goal performance in Columbus at the All-Star game. The first player to ever score four goals in an All-Star game happened right here in 1983. Stay tuned to our Ford intermission report. I'm going to have more on that, guys.
A lead for Nielsen, but he lost the handle as he dribbled one to the net that was stopped by Lundqvist. Thanks, Shannon. Boy, Lars Nielsen almost made Shannon out to be a prophet. I mean, Shannon predicts a goal by an Islander, and he almost gets one before she's even finished talking.
Yeah, that was a great face-off play by the Islanders as Franz Nielsen, after the face-off, took off right up the middle of the ice. You're right, the puck just seemed to get away on him when he went to let that wrist shot go.
Well, let's see. Figure out now if Shannon's on to something or not. DeHaan with a pass up the middle somewhat dangerously. Recovered by Bailey. Stripped away from him by Dominic Moore with 4.5 to go. In a very entertaining first period. That puck hit the linesman's skate. And it's offside with 4:28 to go in the period.
Watch this play develop. Watch Franz Nielsen. He'll keep your eye on him as he's going to come right up the middle of the ice from the far side. That was on a change, I believe. They changed right off the faceoff, Howie. And Franz came out of the bench on a change. Well, I'll get to see if I can get a better look from up above. But I believe the Islanders kind of pulled a fast one, the old sleeper play. As soon as you get a chance to win the faceoffs, you go to the bench at the short end and you come out the deep end, Howie, and you gain 20 feet and you get behind the Rangers. So I want to take another look at that from maybe a little different angle, but I think that was a sleeper play.
Well, you didn't lose the handle on the puck. Might have been a sleeper goal. 15-10 Islanders in shots. Tussle behind the net. Miller winds it around. Now McDonough flips one, blocked away in front. The Islanders go the other way. Tavares, Grabowski exchange. Tavares, nice back check by JT Miller of the Rangers.
As soon as Tavares went sideways a little bit, JT Miller came back in a straight line. So that's what they talked about, back pressure. One of the biggest changes from when I played is we didn't back check that hard unless you were a centerman. Wingers now are forced to come back.
Reminds me of Ziggy Palfy's old line coming off the ice. After a morning skate, muttering loudly enough for anyone to hear, this back-checking is killing me.
Or Pierre LaRouche, you pay me $100,000 to score 50 goals, yeah. You pay me another $100,000, I back-check. And he wasn't kidding.
Yep, you've got to pay extra for that.
Yeah, that's not part of the package in the old days, but it is now. You don't back-check whether you're a forward, defenseman, doesn't matter. You got to be part of the package.
Butterbuck flicks it in. Lundqvist around and out. With 3.5 to go in the period. Brian Strait whirls it around the board. Cizikas heads to the corner. Back to the blue line. Hickey tried to feed the stick of Clutterbuck. And Al Klein dumps it out. Again, the linesman skate gets involved. And Haglund with a drop to Brassard, but his shot goes off of Strait. And ricochets out of play. That's the second time that Tony Saracolo has actually knocked down a puck right at the blue line.
And there's nowhere for him to go. He's got his back end up against the boards. There's no glass to lean on or even to hoist yourself. Remember in the old days, Howie, they used to, glass wasn't as high, and they would just jump on top of the dasher board and get out of the way. Now they can't do that anymore, so poor linesman is a sitting duck.
Every once in a while, you'd see a picture of something like that in the newspaper, and it just was such an unusual thing to grasp as a kid.
Yeah.
Ryan Official was climbing the boards, but
obviously, to get out of the way of a big collision.
And a big shot.
2:54 remaining in the first period. The Islanders have iced the puck, so they'll bring the faceoff back into the Islanders zone. And tomorrow night on MSG, you can catch an all-new episode of Four Courses with J.B. Smoove. You can join J.B. and guests Rick DiPietro, Kurt Melsger, Rashad Jennings, and David Attell tomorrow night at 11:30 after the Knicks on MSG, presented by Cadillac. Girardi's drive blocked away.
A big faceoff again by Stepan. Neither one of these teams is particularly great when you talk about all 30 teams on faceoffs. Tavares has been the best guy so far for the Islanders over the season at almost 52%. Moore is almost 55%, but as a group, they're down around 47%.
Well, you know, again, hats off to Governor Cuomo and to New Jersey Governor Chris Christie, who did a very smart thing last night by ordering everyone off the roads by 11 so that these people could get here in the numbers that they have tonight with surprisingly good conditions. I find once you're able to get out of your own neighborhood,
yep,
and you get onto the main roads, they were practically dry by mid-afternoon.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the ability to keep the roads clean and do their work last night has certainly allowed everyone in the New York area to be able to get on with their normal lives.
Well, thank you to the governors for making that possible. Boychuk fires it off the boards, and the Islanders have iced it again. And they'll bring it right back into the Islanders zone with 2:24 to go in the period. So there's John Tavares, and everybody, John looks to be upset by something here about the icing, but, you know, everybody among Islander fans seems so bent out of shape again about JT not winning the MVP in the All-Star game. It's such a farcical game. I think the only individual trophy a fan really should want to see JT win would be the Conn Smythe Trophy.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because then you're in business.
Yeah, then you're, well, yeah, you're, then more than likely you'd want a Stanley Cup.
Yep. With rare exception, Bailey's drive turned away.
Now, when you have the best performance in the All-Star game, though, you expect to get a little rewarded. And typical John Tavares handled extremely well. But he wasn't there to win the MVP. He was there to have fun.
Tavares across, Boychuk, now Bailey to Grabowski, they score! Oh, what a tic-tac-toe series of plays. Islanders lead it 1-0.
It just doesn't get a whole lot better than that, Howie. You talk about having patience and quick puck movement and guys stopping. Nobody was behind the goal line. They all stopped, got themselves into position, and Grabowski pays early dividends again for the Islanders. Tavares back over to Boychuk to Leddy, and look at Grabowski sitting all alone, all wide open. There's the first pass. Boychuk back over to Bailey. Look at Grabowski. Nobody's got Grabowski, so the Islanders take advantage of a couple of Ranger miscues. And boy, oh boy, was that terrific passing.
That was a thing of beauty. If you could draw comparisons between different sports, boy, the Islanders right there looked like Red Holtzman's Knicks of many, many years ago. That was absolutely gorgeous.
You just don't see a lot of plays like that. Grabowski was covered early, but he didn't go for the skate. He just stopped in the slot area and was able to take advantage of an opportunity set up with Bailey and Boychuk in the initial play by Tavares.
Minute and a half to go in the period. Grabowski from Bailey and Boychuk at 18:05. For Bailey, he's 1 point shy of 200 for his career. Grabowski with his seventh goal of the year, as he's back in the lineup tonight from the lower body injury.
Well, his buddy has been scoring goals with a great abundance, and I'm talking about Huttman, or Kuhlman, I guess is his real name, but I call him the Huttman because that's what he's been. And the Grabowski has to match his buddy.
Some fans have been have taken to calling Nikolai Cool Lemon.
Cool Lemon.
Well, icing call, and they'll bring the puck deep into the...
Well, he's been a hot tamale, really. But look at the play. Tavares takes a wide. You can see Kuhlman driving towards him. We'll watch him as he stops and puts himself in position. A little tap on the ice, saying, hey, Bales, I'm wide open. So many good things on that play. Again, the defenseman jumping up on the play, Howie, and giving the forwards an opportunity to make a pass to him.
Imagine all that. John Tavares is behind the goal line just taking it all in.
I did my job. And, you know, he was complaining to the linesman about the faceoff, and then he goes and he wins the faceoff, which started the whole play.
Shannon, you are a genius.
Yeah, she's looking awful smart right now.
35 seconds to go in the period. She called it. Klein with a drive. That sails wide. Now Haglund for the Rangers.
17 shots, Howie, for the Islanders in this period.
And Kevin Hayes put it to the front. Deflected away by Strait. 18 to go in the period. Abner lofts one ahead. The Klein tries to bat out but can't. Kept alive by Kulinen. Nelson around. DeMartin. 7 in the period. Brock Nelson tangled up with Hunwick. And at the end of one, on as pretty a play as you will ever see in a real hockey game, never mind the All-Star game, the Kyle Grabowski finishes. Bailey, Boychuk, I think everybody but Goring, Bossy, Trottier got in on that goal. But Grabowski with the only goal of the period at 18:05. The Islanders, who outshot the Rangers 17-10, leave the ice with a 1-0 lead. Coming up, the clairvoyant Ms. Shannon will be along with the goal scorer, Mikhail Grabowski. Again, all-star recap plus highlights of this first period. A hard-hitting period, one that also featured a lot of scoring chances. The Islanders cash in 1-0 at the end of one. The Islanders on their way out to start the second period with a 1-0 lead. Introducing MSG Go, the only app that lets you watch MSG Network's coverage of live Knicks games anywhere. Download now in the App Store or Google Play. MSG Go is currently available to Optimum subscribers. So the second period about to begin. We bring you tonight's Cadillac trivia question. There have been just two players, I mentioned the Conn Smythe before, award my partner here, one. Well, there are just two players who have won both the Masterton and the Lady Byng trophies. The Lady Byng for sportsmanship. The Masterson includes sportsmanship and its criteria for perseverance and such. And it was right around this time of year, Butch, that I recall when Bill Bat Masterson, as he was called, died tragically in an on-ice accident. He was playing for the Minnesota North Stars. I think it was the first year of expansion, 67-68.
I think it was Masterton.
Mixed up with that old character, Bat Masterson, which is why he was given that
But now
nickname.
You're dating yourself,
yeah,
too.
Well, somebody had to. But I just recall that he hit his head. They weren't wearing helmets back then, and he fell backwards, right. Hit his head on the ice, and died a day or so later. And the Masterton Trophy was named after Bill Masterton.
Yes, exactly. And for all the young people out there who are itching to skate, please wear a helmet, because if you do fall backwards, bad things happen.
So, and if you're good enough helmet, to make it to the NHL, you're only going to have to wear one anyway.
Yeah, that's true enough.
Hey, let me ask you about that, one more thing about that goal, because I mentioned Red Holzman's Knicks, who taught a generation that it was just as much fun to make the great pass that leads to the basket as the guy who scores it. He made a lot of passes that led directly to goals. Did you derive almost, in some cases, as much satisfaction from setting up a particular goal as you did from scoring?
Yeah, you really do. You get great satisfaction in making a good play. And you know, for a lot of the guys, it's in their DNA to pass before they shoot. And making a play like that, like Bailey and Donnie Boychuk, you feel pretty good.
And a save by Halak on a fleet from the blue line by Boyle. So that play, certainly the highlight of the first period.
And more importantly, Howie, is Grabowski felt pretty good about it, because he would recognize that was an unselfish play by Bailey, but it was also a really smart play. You know, so he got himself in a position. And a lot of times, as a player, you get yourself in position and the guy doesn't pass it to you. And then you get a little ticked off because you're saying, hey, I'm serious. No, I'm right there. I'm wide open. It's a fast-paced game. You don't see every play. So you're very appreciative when it does happen.
Now from the draw, the puck at the circle, recovered by Grabowski, and he powers up the left side with a feed on the right to Bailey. Josh Bailey checked by Ryan McDonough. That turned the puck over. Bailey gets it again. Slips one on to Tavares. Shovels it rink-wide to DeHaan. He throws one on goal that Lundqvist squeezes. It'll be a face-off in the Rangers' zone.
Well, it's important that the Islanders get off to a good start in this first 5 minutes. They established a real good pace in that first period. I liked a lot of things that they did. They got the puck in deep. They drove the defenseman back off the blue line, so it allowed them to carry the puck with a lot of speed, get inside, and maintain some ozone control. But don't turn the puck. Don't get into a, make it a short track, as Jack Capuano likes to say. Make him come
200 feet for every one of their opportunities.
And certainly not a slow track tonight.
No, no.
But more of a track meet.
And we got the sprinters out. Got the handicap horses running today.
Kuhlman actually lost it to the side of the cage there. But now Stepan up the right side to a speedy Kreider driving in on Hamannik, who stayed with him. Kreider barrels into the net. There's going to be a penalty. I think there's going to be on Kreider for running into a lock.
Yeah, and it's a call that they make today. It's a call that I don't particularly like, because Kreider was trying to get around the defenseman and tried to hold up and just lost his edge and slid into Halak. That's a tough call. Kreider's got tremendous speed. Look at, he leans in, tries to put the brakes on, but you know what? He put him on too late, Howie. He needed to go a little sooner, but that's tough when you're going 30 miles an hour. To make that kind of a decision, a split-second decision, when to turn, when can you get in front of the defenseman? That's the tough calls on forwards in today's game.
And then Halak said, well, take this anyway.
Well, you get the obligatory push.
So, it's an Islander power play brought to you by the New York Lottery. Hey, you never know. 59 seconds, time of Kreider's goalie interference penalty. Islanders 1-for-5 on the power play against the Rangers in the two games this year as the Islanders go offside. And again, that power play for the Islanders has been up and down and up and down. Well, they've scored power play goals now in 3 straight games. Of course, this is their first game in over a week, so we'll see if it carries over.
Yeah, they were 3 for 9, and that was a well-executed entry. Doug Wade will not be happy that one of the boys went offside, because Tavares came in on the outside as a specific play, and you don't get a lot of specific plays in hockey, but that was one of them that executed almost perfect.
Nielsen, Boychuk, Tavares, Strome, and Nelson, the Islander power play. Nielsen over to the boards. Nice feed to Boychuk with that big shot. Hands off to Tavares along the boards. Outlets to Nielsen and then Boychuk. They play catch. This is Boychuk straight away to Tavares. It's a screen in front. Now moves it to the corner. Nielsen to Nielsen. Nielsen again. Rangers box up. Boychuk hustled over to the near side. Now darting the other way. Gets there to accept the pass. Fires. Save Lundqvist. Boychuk again. Ronnie Boychuk to Nielsen. 45 to the power play. And that came over the line. A play offside.
Yeah, that was real, real close. The linesman obviously right on the blue line. I'm not sure he got a full look at it because Boychuk had him screened just a little bit. Watch to see if that puck comes entirely out.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Yeah, that's a close call, but I always maintain, err on that side, because then you just never know. I have no problems with that call.
Well, Moore thrown out of the draw. And Grabowski beats Hanglin.
Second power play. And this is an area where Kyle Apostle, who we missed, is on the power play. He's been an integral part of the Islanders' power play. And Ryan Strome moved up to the number one. And looks like Grabowski will get more action.
Lee didn't get anything on that pass, so Hanglin speeds ahead, trailed by Moore, got it to Moore, who shoved a weak one on goal that Halak stopped, but now just 15 seconds remain to the Islander power play, and Moore keeps the heat on Josh Bailey. And that effectively will take care of the penalty. Kreider set to come out of the box. One shot for the Islanders, but here's Lee, stripped of the puck, teams at full strength now. Kreider back in the play. And here comes Kreider with those great wheels, working on straight. Pitches one towards himself. Takes the bump from straight. Now to Fast. For Fast, number 19 for the Rangers. Along the boards to Boyle. Shot it off Grabowski. And Martin. Just bounces one into neutral ice. 3.5 gone here in the second period. Hunwick dumps into the far corner. Hamannik works it around to Martin. Chipped it past Hunwick. Brought along by Grabowski. Into the Rangers zone. He swings into the slot. Broken up and cleared all the way down by Nash, but straight to Halak. So there's no icing. Straight chased by Zuccarello. And Hunwick plays it right back into the Islander end of the ice. Rangers changing on the move. Up the right side comes Cizikas for the Islanders. He loses his balance, but holds on to the puck.
Whirls it in behind for Martin. Out of the slot. Cizikas a shot. Save. Rebound. Score. Matt Martin. The fourth line comes through again. And the Islanders lead it 2-0.
And they do it with old-fashioned checking and a little chip in and go get the puck. Casey Cizikas is able to get the puck just over the blue line, come down with speed, and then the Islanders go to work on a little bit of cycling. Good position, get yourself in front of the net, but it's Matt Martin who's going to finish it off with his seventh goal of the season. Both Cizikas and Clutterbuck are in front of the net, but it started with a good play, a chip along the boards with Casey Cizikas getting it down low, and then both forwards, Clutterbuck and Cizikas going into the slot area. What a terrific play, and you're right, Howie, they strike again. The MC square line.
Yeah, I was waiting for you to bring that up. Well, the theory of relativity, whatever that was supposed to have been, but who's going to argue with Einstein, yields to a similar moniker for a hockey line. Martin, Clutterbuck, and Cizikas. All three of them involved. Martin with a goal. 2-0 Islanders. Clutterbuck and Cizikas drawing the assists on Martin's seventh at 4:11 in the second period. Stahl gets out of the way of a Kuhlman hit.
New York Islanders goal, score number 17.
And we get a whistle and a penalty coming here. And this one, I believe, is going to go against Kuhlman, and the Rangers will get their first power play.
Yeah, that was the aggressive forecheck by Kuhlman, dumping Stahl. Looked to me like Kuhlman just came in real, real hard on Stahl. Here's Matt Martin in front of the net, and then he just, you know, anticipates the pucks coming loose, and they know that there's going to be a player in the high slot. They practice that particular drill. Kuhlman does extend his right leg and trips Stahl, so it's a good call by the referee. You got to keep your legs in a normal stance, if you will, a normal skating position in hockey. Kuhlman didn't do that.
So the Rangers win the draw, but Boyle fails to hold the puck. Boyle, St. Louis, Stepan, Brassard, and Nash, the Ranger power play. Rangers 0-4 in two games against the Islanders this year. Remember, Franz Nielsen has a shorthanded goal. Chance for Nash, save made by Halak. And it's brought on by DeHaan, finds the opening, and bounces one that Lundqvist rather adroitly pushes to the corner.
Rangers have only been 1-for-17 in their last six games, Howie, but that was a great opportunity. Franz Nielsen and Ryan Strome got caught out of position.
Brassard, a drive up high. It got Halak, but he's got the puck. And it'll be a face-off in the Islanders' zone.
Well, I was talking to Kyle Clutterbuck earlier today, or just before the game started, a little bench hit. Asked him why, when there's pushing and shoving and the referees get involved. There's a nice save, as good positioning, but watch the pushing and the shoving. Why is it always Clutterbuck that's involved in it? I said, well, that's my game. It's always been my game. And we watch Clutterbuck, and he gets in there, and then the referees get in there. He's just having fun. He's just at home in those kind of situations.
Well, you played against a guy they called Super Pest, Brian Watson.
Yes.
I don't know if you could draw comparisons necessarily between Watson and Clutterbuck, but same effect.
Yeah, exactly. They just had a way of getting under everybody's skin, little pushes, little shoves, little jabs to the back of the head or the back of the legs. Anything to agitate you, to get you off your game.
Bugsy Watson, they called him. And the puck cleared out by Boychuk.
I used to check Bobby Howe and Gordie Howe, and used to drive them nuts.
Called him a shadow, right?
Oh, yeah.
Here comes Boyle now. Minute 6 left to the Ranger power play. Drops one to Brassard. And over the Islander line, he's surrounded. Gets help from Nash. Played it across. Boyle into the corner now. Banks it back to the blue line. St. Louis waits. Marty St. Louis to Stepan. Derek Stepan with a little room. Angled towards the boards by Nielsen. Connects with St. Louis. And across. Brassard to St. Louis. Now Stepan a drive, and that skips wide. Maybe Halak got a piece of it. 35 to the power play. This is Boyle lining it up. Doesn't shoot. Brassard to St. Louis. Nash is in front. Brassard to St. Louis. Send back to Boyle. A bouncing puck. Now to Stepan and then Boyle again. St. Louis to Nash. 15 to the power play. Boyle. What about a shot? Doesn't shoot. Now Stepan does. Halak's got it. And there's no further play with 8 seconds remaining on the Kuhlman penalty.
Rangers had all kinds of control, were able to move the puck around with some pretty good precision, using Marty St. Louis really as the passer. There's a seam pass. Stepan gets quite a bit, but watch Halak. He's been able to, he's down low, he's watching, and slides across, protects that post. You can see him locking himself in, how he's watching low and going post to post. Good hard pushes with Halak. But the ability to pick up that puck really aided his ability to stop it.
Well, from the draw, DeHaan slams it off the boards and all the way down, and that takes care of the power play. The Rangers had three shots, but the team's now at full strength.
Well, the best penalty killer on that particular play was the goaltender. He made several real good saves for the Islanders.
Zuccarello in behind the Islanders goal. Back to the line, Girardi, one-timer blocked. Out come the Islanders. Oh, a pass by Cizikas has just missed, sending Kuhlman in. Kuhlman on his way to the bench.
That was a good try by Cizikas. Kuhlman going right up the gut, recognizing the opportunity.
Nice passing again. Tavares had it poked away by McDonough. Tavares just about shrugged off Dan Girardi. It's helped from Clutterbuck. Girardi back to Tavares.
Tavares really, in my opinion, trying to send a message to the Rangers about his style of play.
Again, Girardi on Tavares. Good battle there. And it's swept out by Miller, but that's going to be an icing call against the New York Rangers. And they'll bring it into Henrik Lundqvist's neighborhood. Well, I agree with you, Butch. Tavares looks like he's actually got another gear tonight.
Yeah, he really does. He has some real bite to his game. And I didn't get a chance to talk to him from the All-Star break. And, you know, obviously they have, there's a lot going on there, but he looks very refreshed. But he just has a little different focus. There's something in his eye in tonight's game, and it's a good thing.
JT wins the draw. A shot by Strait deflects away. Girardi first to get it. Bosch trying to pound it out of the zone. Could not, but Miller skates it out. Miller against Strait. Haglund joining. Nice play by Strait. Haglund finally grabs it behind the Islander net. Tries a wraparound, nothing doing there. And out come the Islanders. Tavares throws it around the board.
And a nice job of back checking on Haglund by Grabowski. Not many people can go stride to stride with Haglund. He's very, very fast.
Now Fosh, not fast. Don't mean to criticize his speed. It's pronounced Fost, F-A-S-T.
And he is fast.
Yes. Stahl, a wrister, and that's blocked. Mark Stahl recently signed a contract extension with the Rangers.
Ka-ching.
Yep. Here's Stahl lining up, firing one wide. Fost recovers. Hassled by Brock Nelson. Now Hayes to Klein. Wrist shot stopped by the stick of Halak. Rangers trying to keep that rolling puck alive. Klein does. Finds Dominic Moore behind the net, but Boychuk finds Moore. Moore bounces off. Boychuk keeps the heat on. Now Boyle of the Rangers. Tangled up with Nelson. And up to center comes Grabner.
Good smart play by Grabner. Extended time in the defensive zone by the Islanders. Allowed them a chance to change with that Michael Grabner chip.
Glass lining up DeHaan.
Too many men on the ice, and the referees missed it.
This is Cizikas was dumped by Glass. And here's a lead just a shade too far for Martin.
I don't know why that's icing.
I wouldn't be surprised to see him drop this puck at center, Butch.
Yeah, that was a miscue by the linesman.
I think the referee caught that as well.
There was two miscues. They missed the too many men on the ice by the Rangers just about 30 seconds ago. And that was a call where Matt Martin clearly had position to get in on first on the forecheck. It'll be interesting to see now if the Islanders can push back a little bit. The power play opportunity for the Rangers, albeit they didn't score, they seem to have been able to gather some momentum in that place. As we watched Marty St. Louis put the puck at the dot. But there's the play by Matt Martin. You can clearly see he's ahead of the play. No dots involved. Now the referees are explaining, and Jack Capuano wants to know what's going on.
I thought the referee had already decided that they'd made the mistake and they were going to drop it at center.
Yeah, that's now they're talking over again. So this is not a final yet, I don't think.
I don't know. The Islanders don't look happy about the way it's being resolved.
Now the referee's going to the other referee's going to the timekeepers.
It looked like Martin clearly had the step, and that the referee pointed to center ice almost immediately as though to say, all right, look, we made a mistake. But
and not only that, Howie, neither one of those guys had really got anywhere near the dot. They were still just really at the tops of the circle. The dots is supposed to be, I believe, is supposed to be the criteria. So I'm a little miffed at that particular call.
Islanders lose the argument. And from the draw, the Islanders control it anyway. Matt Martin chips one along. Batted back to center. DeHaan. Now for Hamonic.
Now let's check here. And used to say, no harm, no foul.
Long time great voice of the L.A. Lakers. Kreider overskates it, then gets it from Stepan. Across to Derek Stepan. In front looking for Hunwick, and he deflects it out of play.
That good speed of Kreider is able to create some offense for the Rangers. Islanders still lead 2-0.
The schedule's really going to get busy now. Bruins will be here Thursday night. Then it's on to Detroit for a day game on Saturday with the Red Wings. 2 days off. And then the Florida Panthers will be in here on Tuesday night. Well, you would think the Islander fan would be the one with the larger grin right about now, where the Islanders leading 2-0. Well, he's earned the right to that smile. So, Brassard will draw with Nielsen. The Islanders control.
I'm going to say how it'd be the Bruins' first time in the Coliseum this year.
They're going to practice here tomorrow. Ryan Strome in over the line to Nielsen. There were times when Harry Sinden would bring the Bruins here on game day. Brassard to Nash. A save. Halak. He didn't quite control the rebound, which is pitched to the corner. Brassard behind the net. Out of Nash. Rick Nash, a shot save made. Rebound stall. Halak got an arm on that. Stall again. The slot. Nash turns and shoots. That's blocked. Islanders put up a wall in front of Halak there.
They really have. And when they didn't need to, Halak was there.
Hamonic joins in. Can't get to the net. Control of that fluttering puck. But he keeps working behind the Ranger goal line. Tavares covering for him. Back of the blue line. And now the Islanders start to change. Make a quick turn ahead to Strome. Now to Tavares. Shoots wide. Rebound. Strome. And it's off the crossbar, according to the referee. Play continues. Might have another look at that eventually. Haglin in. Haglin now for Hayes. Could not clearly tell from our vantage point with a naked eye whether that actually made its way into the net or not. Video review will confirm one way or the other, either the referee's call or the suspicion.
And the referee was in perfect position too, Howie. He was only about 3-4 feet away from that particular attempt, just in behind the net.
And now Grabowski doesn't get it further ahead.
And a few more turnovers for the Islanders than we saw in the first period. And to stay within the game plan, again, force the Rangers to play down low.
8:02 remaining here in the second period. Ryan McDonough up the boards, but he took a hit. Glass the puck across to Miller. Quick shot save. Halak. He has been short. Good right pad save there by Yarrow.
A nice job of tracking by Letty. He's able to get him deep and protect the rebound.
Line rink wide to Glass. Long drive turned away by Lundqvist. Let's turn that stick to direct the puck right into the corner. Keep it out of harm's way.
Roger Kozier used to call that housekeeping in his Detroit Red Wing days. But Halak looks solid in net. I mean, very little movement except for when he has to make a save. He's very calm, very cool, very collective in net right now.
Your good buddy Billy Smith was one of the best at that too, wasn't he?
Yeah, he sure was.
Turn that stick. Martin floats it right through the goal mouth.
You don't see it as much now because they defend with their pads.
Ryder. And it's blocked. Was by Hamonic. Now St. Louis to McDonough. Tip up high by Stepan. The Rangers getting a little more pressure now. They have outshot the Islanders 23-21. 6:49 to go in the second.
A lot of shots on that one power play, but they definitely got their skating legs going much better in this period.
McDonough put it out in front. DeHaan swept it away. DeHaan looks for Stepan. McDonough joins in. Ryan McDonough. back for Stepan. Now DeHaan tries to hold off Nash. Chipped it away. Grabner fires it ahead to Kuhlman. Nikolai Kuhlman with a quick shot that's gloved by Lundqvist. And there's no further play. 6:20 remaining. Second period. 2-0 Islanders.
Ryan Strome comes so close to giving the Islanders a 3-0 lead at the Nassau Coliseum on the backhand. Puck loose. There it is on the backhand by Ryan Strome, and it just hits the crossbar. You always talk about it as a game of inches here and there, Howie. Ryan Strome with that curve couldn't keep the puck any lower and still get it over Lundqvist.
So it remains 2-0 Islanders. Rangers, though, have outshot the Islanders here in the second period, 13-4. 23-21 for the game. And it's been kind of a game of pushes.
It really has.
Significant length by either team.
Both these teams are very, very good hockey teams.
Save made on Nielsen's shot. Hamonic chipping at it, but the whistle blows, and now Hamonic is caught in between three Rangers. Rick Nash, Matt Zuccarello, Kevin Klein.
Well, Hamonic gets an opportunity on the rebound shot from Franz Nielsen, and then just keeps going right to the net. Franz with the first opportunity. Lundqvist makes a nice save, but look at Travis Hamonic goes in and says, well, I'm not quite done yet. There's a loose puck for me. I'll just see if I can't get it to the back of the net. Travis, much more aggressive player going towards the net this year than he's been at any point in time in his career. Must enjoy scoring.
I don't know why he wouldn't. He scored one of those Bobby Orr highlight reel goals last year. That doesn't get you hooked on the idea. What will? Nash has to wait for Brassard to get out.
Well, he always talks about adding more to his game each and every year.
Hahn worked that to the near corner. Franz Nielsen in between a pair of Rangers has support from Hamonic, but Zuccarello wins the puck. Nash wrap around. He put it right through the goal crease, right at the far edge.
Talk about a long reach. Rick Nash.
Brassard trying to stuff it. Nothing doing there. And now Strome chips one ahead towards himself. Stahl stays with him. Played by Ryan Strome. Islanders got that long change in.
Now the two of them are going at it. It's a couple of 18s over there.
Cizikas to Hickey. Pass was missed by Martin, and this one will be an icing with quite a bit less arguing than there was last time.
Well, tied for first place in the league with 28 goals. You can see why when you have that kind of a reach, that kind of skill. But Halak, again, looks so sharp at going post to post. And every time I see a goaltender do that, it gives me a little cringe because that's just really difficult on the groins. Rick Nash has had a special season for the New York Rangers. Halak, a special season for the Islanders.
Boyle, a shot blocked, and out come the Islanders led by Hickey. Right wing, it's Clutterbuck. Going one to the far side. Cizikas against Boyle. Now the scrum ensues with Martin knocked down right of the faceoff circle. So it's Hickey firing, blocked by the skate of Hunwick. Hunwick and Martin go to the corner.
This is what this line does so well, as they protect the puck. They make you pay. They finish their checks all the time. They're just miserable guys to play against, Howie.
More agitation, but nothing results. 4:40 to go in the second. Tonight on MSG, the Knicks take on the Thunder. Live coverage begins with Visa Knicks game night at 7:30 p.m. Knicks and Thunder tomorrow night on MSG Network, and also available on MSG Go. MSG Go is currently available to Optimum subscribers. Well, the Islanders came in tonight leading Pittsburgh by 3 points. The teams, even in games played, Islanders atop the Metropolitan Division. And the Winnipeg Jets are leading Pittsburgh 2-1 late in the second period. Rangers are 5 points behind the Islanders, sitting third. And the Rangers have played two fewer games.
Pittsburgh has no Crosby and no Malkin for a little while.
Knocked down in front was Clutterbuck. Always gives the Pittsburgh Penguins a much different look and feel, but they've been dealing with injuries and illness all year.
Between them and Columbus, you could put a team together of injured people.
And again, we wish Kyle Okposo the best. All we know for sure is that he's expected to miss between 6 and 8 weeks with some sort of an upper body injury.
Yeah, and he really had picked up his game. I mean, he was hot. The Islanders will certainly miss him.
Now McDonough launches one. It gives Halak trouble, but he covers. Gets the whistle. And another scrum ensues. And boy, would you love to see these teams play, never mind seven or eight times in the regular season. Just get them together for a playoff series and get this rivalry back where it used to be. It's showing signs now.
Oh, it is, and you can see the intensity, and there's starting to be a little hate between some of the guys. And it's possible they could meet in a conference final. There's the quick shot from a bad angle. It's underneath the pad, but driving towards the net is Dominic Moore. He's always a guy that'll go to those dirty areas. Good fourth line center for the Rangers. Very good on faceoffs. Good penalty killer.
And you know, the hostilities, such as they are not about fighting or even penalties per se. It's just about what you saw at the whistle. What we're seeing punctuate virtually every whistle. Shoving, pushing somebody in somebody else's face. There haven't been any fights between the teams in the 2.5 games they've played this season. And only 30 penalty minutes combined.
Yeah, and it's a big game. I mean, sure, there's lots of hockey left, but it's not just a game about rivalry. It's about positioning. The Islanders have good position on these guys. When you're talking about, winning the division and having home ice, these are important elements to the game, and the Rangers are their biggest foe.
Nash to Brassard. Nice pass. Brassard put it off of Halak. Bounces right to the stick of Hamonic, who flings it off the boards. And again, the Rangers getting a little push now as Nash powers in. Here's Zuccarello with the slot shooting, and that might have ticked the glove of Halak, and the Islanders look to attack. A drop pass from Tavares sends Kuhlman ahead, and Lundqvist steers it away.
The Rangers have been able to come up the ice through the neutral zone with a lot more control and a lot more speed. One of the areas that Jack Capuano wanted his team to improve on was tracking through the neutral zone.
Islanders keep it alive. Letty to Boychuk. Wrister. Blocker save made by Lundqvist. Garams to Kuhlman. 2:39 to go in the period. Boychuk over. Doesn't slap that puck deep. Instead, it Garams the other way, forcing Kuhlman to come back to get it behind the Islander goal line.
Now, what I mean about that tracking properly is getting back and picking up the late men. Rangers have been able to shake some guys loose coming up the ice.
Grabner in. Soft feed to Nelson. Bouncing puck. Maintains possession. Played by Brock Nelson. Straight engages. Straight. Put it to the net. Lundqvist's got that. Off an empty play by Brian Straight with 2:04 remaining in the second period. Well, fans, stay tuned for the second period intermission report presented by Chevrolet. Shannon will be busy. She'll be chatting with Matt Martin, who has the second period goal for the Islanders, and will also be joined by the commissioner of the National Hockey League, Gary Bettman, who is in the building tonight, and will have second period highlights as well.
We'll watch the offensive opportunity by Brian Straight, who has played very well with Vishnowski being out.
Straight, a shot blocker, save, rebound, Lee blocked by Klein. No chance there for Anders Lee.
Yeah, all set up again. Faceoffs are so important. Big faceoff win by Ryan Strome, I believe, that time.
Good to see the commissioner at the Coliseum. Former Islander fan, you know.
Yeah, he can't be an Islander fan. At least he could be in the closet with his being an Islander fan, but not open.
Stahl with a wrister, gloved by Halak.
Yeah, he keeps telling me that he used to like watching me play and our teams back in the 80s. But he doesn't say as much now, and I understand. But look at the good faceoff win by Ryan Strome. Brian Straight gets it through, and Lee has that opportunity. Can't quite handle it. Would have liked just to have a little more time as we watch Stahl with a quick wrist shot, but Halak sees it all the way and able to trap that puck with that big white trapper.
Minute 36 to go in the period. Hayes wins a draw to Boyle. Centering feed. And off a stick to the near boards. Rangers spending a lot more time in the Islander zone lately. Nash to Stefan, sharp angle, and Halak's got that. And Yaroslav Halak becoming a bigger and bigger story as this game is now nearly two periods old.
It's been a good push by the Rangers, and they're really shooting the puck from anywhere and everywhere and driving towards the net. But the Islander defense has done a real nice job of being able to watch the guys and block them out, allowing Halak to make the saves or to pick up the rebound. So they haven't been outmanned in front of the net. Halak has been solid, but the play in front of him has been very, very good also, Howie.
Brassard beaten on a faceoff by Casey Cizikas. Clutterbuck lifts it out of the zone. Bounce behind Cizikas, allowing the Rangers to drive it back in. Clutterbuck challenged by Zuccarello. Brassard has it in the corner. As we come down to the final minute of the period, McDonough to the slot. Martin's got that. The Islanders come ahead. Aminik up to the Ranger line. Cross to Cizikas. Now Martin a shot. And Lundqvist sprawls. Where's the puck? I believe there's going to be an interference penalty here. And now things are on the verge of, if not getting out of control, at least evolving into something that will create more penalty time. Remember, there have not been any fights yet between these teams this year, but they've come close.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be an interference call on Lundqvist, because I was wondering why Lundqvist was down on all fours on that Matt Martin attempt. Nice play by Travis Hamonic. Cizikas gets the shot away, and there's the interference as Clutterbuck pushes the Ranger defender into the net. No chance for Brassard, no chance for Lundqvist. Good call by the referee on Clutterbuck as he pushes off. It's a strength play. But again,
New York Islanders
number 15.
2 minutes interference.
As usual, number 15 in the middle of stuff.
Well, it means a penalty kill for the Islanders with 47 seconds remaining in the second period. If the Rangers don't score before then, penalty will carry over into the third for a minute and 13. Rangers 0-for-1, but they did have three shots and moved it very well.
A lot of good opportunities too. And that's not a good penalty for Cal. You know, sometimes you got to rein in your aggressiveness. You got to be smart. I know Cal pushes the envelope here and there once in a while. That's part of his game, and he's very effective. Because sometimes you got to manage the clock too, Howie. With less than a minute to go, you got to back off a little bit, make sure you don't get called for anything that's a little petty. Now this faceoff is going to be important for the Islanders.
So Nielsen and Miller on that big draw. Rangers control. Boyle for a one-timer by St. Louis. Steered away by Halak. Kulam and Boychuk. Hickey and Nielsen. Islander penalty killers. Referee getting involved there. And Kreider has one deflect over the glass with exactly 30 seconds remaining. And now again a discussion as to where the faceoff will be.
Went off at Hickey's stick, so it'll be in the defensive zone. Islanders had a chance to clear it. Hickey was on his backhand. Decided to go up the boards with it. Perhaps didn't have a good enough angle to loop it up through the middle of the ice. Islanders, again, working with a lot of pressure in the defensive zone, trying to make sure the Rangers don't have any real good time.
Boychuk slams it off the boards. Boyle tried to keep it, could not. Now Strome has Cizikas go into the net. He just missed him with a pass. Cizikas with 20 to go in the period. Would love to just keep this puck deep, take at least that time off the clock, and let the third period begin with the Rangers on a power play. They've got 10 seconds left here. Brassard drops it, broke it up, cleared out of the zone, and that will take care of the second period. Matt Martin with the only goal. Rangers will have a power play for a minute and 14 seconds when we begin the third period. But Yaroslav Halak has been downright brilliant, and it is 2-0 Islanders at the end of two.
No doubt he was the difference in the second period. Rangers came with a lot more offensive thrust, created several really good opportunities, but Halak was strong. If the Islanders were able to maintain their own offensive opportunities, and that was a big goal by Matt Martin to establish a 2-0 lead. But the Islanders will have to pick up the pace just a little bit in this third period, play a little more in the offensive zone.
Rangers outshot the Islanders 18-11 in the period, 28 shots for each team through two, and it's 2-0 New York. So coming up in our Chevrolet intermission report, Shannon will chat with Matt Martin of the Islanders and the commissioner of the National Hockey League, Gary Bettman. It's all straight ahead. Well, here's our game recap brought to you by your Tri-Honda dealers. Bofsky and Martin with a goal. Bailey points in four straight. Halak brilliant through 40 minutes. But the Islanders still going to have to kill a minute and 13 seconds of Ranger power play time with Clutterbuck still in the box.
And this would be as an important time as any time during this game, is to be able to find their way through this PK for the Islanders. The Rangers could certainly build an awful lot of momentum off a power play goal.
So, Rangers control the draw. They've got Boyle, Brassard, Nash, St. Louis, and Stepan. The Islanders up front, Nielsen and Kuhlman. On defense, Hickey and Boychuk. And it's Nielsen fanning as he tried to work it around the board. So now Hickey has to deal with a much bigger Rick Nash, who connects with Boyle at the point. St. Louis for Brassard. And now Stepan, angled by Nielsen. Brassard against Boychuk. It feeds Stepan to Boyle, lines up a shot, doesn't take it. St. Louis now. Back for Boyle, 30 to the power play. St. Louis to Nash, all the way to Stepan to the other side. Now it's Boyle to Stepan. Derek Stepan forced back to the boards. Now to Boyle, a drive tip. Halak got that with his stick. Great save on a redirection. Kuhlman stripped by Nash. 10 to the power play. Boyle to Brassard. Stepan, too wide for Boyle. And that'll take care of the power play for the Rangers. Clutterbuck is out of the box.
Yeah, that was a good read at the very end of that PK by Johnny Boychuk, getting the stick in that passing lane as Stepan attempted to get it back to the point.
Now it's Miller into the Islander zone. Squeezes one to the net. That's held by Halak. And there'll be a face-off in the Islander zone. So the most immediate objective at the beginning of this third period, kill the penalty, cross that off the Islanders list.
Yeah, you know, there's Boyle in that deflection shot, perfectly set up. And Brassard was in a real nice spot to get that shot on net. But what a read by Halak, as he read the pass shot and just slid right over. Brassard did what he needed to do, but Halak was even better.
Hickey works it around the boards. Martin up by Girardi. Martin protects the puck neatly, though. So the Islanders with their fourth line out. Clutterbuck just out of the penalty box under pressure from Miller. And Zuccarello hit by Clutterbuck, and only now do the Islanders gain firm control of the puck as the Rangers change.
Islanders, Cizikas line, 18 hits after two periods, Howie, and the entire Islander team had 32, so fourth line doing their thing.
As usual.
Yeah, as usual. They're just a very, very consistent group that plays solid defensive hockey, plays a physical element to the game, and scores goals.
Haglin with speed around, wraps it right out in front. Now Moore's got to chase it to the corner. Back to the near side, a little wide for Haglin. He catches up to it. Haglin out of Klein, who might not have been expecting it. Stall a drive. Halak's got that, and there's no further play. Stall could shoot it.
They all could shoot in this league with the brand new sticks. We talked about the speed of Haglin. He's on the left side, number 62. He just turns on the jets, tries a little wraparound, but Halak's got that all figured out. Letty stayed with him, so make sure he couldn't cut right in front of the net, but that man there has got all kinds of speed. But the best thing to do is to keep him on the outside. Eventually, he's going to run out of room.
Strome risks it up the near boards, looking for Lee. He's tangled up with Klein and shows Klein a seat. This is Letty spinning it towards Lee behind the net. Lee, Strome, and Nielsen. Islander forward line. And Kreider moved it away from Lee, but right to Derek Stepan. St. Louis couldn't locate it. Letty slapped it away from him. And out come the Rangers. Kreider to St. Louis. Trying to get it back to Kreider, but Hickey got a piece of it. O'Brien straight up the right wing. And Lundqvist off the glass. Off the linesman's skate. And dumped in by Brassard. Malacca stopped all 31 Ranger shots. The Islanders with 28. And Matt Hunwick now, watched by Kuhlman. Kuhlman forces Hunwick to the board. Second Islander in for the puck is Nelson. Brock Nelson shooting off the side of the net. Hunwick against Nelson. Hunwick moved it to Boyle, and the Rangers will come out here led by Nash. Big Rick Nash in over the line. A drop for Brassard. Nelson breaks up a pass intended for Zuccarello.
Well, you talk about tracking on the backside. That was Brock Nelson doing it to perfection. Make sure you're ahead of that Ranger would-be shooter. Protect the neutral, the middle of the ice, able to deflect that attempted pass. So that's what we're talking about, tracking, coming back, putting yourself in good position, not getting beat up the ice.
Well, again, due to the weather, not that it was all that bad when we left to come to the rink tonight. Scattered empty seats, but they're all sold. Islanders with their sixth consecutive sellout. They've sold out 8 of their last 9. 12 out of the 21 that have been played here at the Coliseum. In the final season, 1255 Hempstead Turnpike, Uniondale, New York.
Now some of the fans weren't able to get away from some of the areas that they were living in, I'm sure. Disappointed.
Especially those out in Suffolk, Eastern Suffolk. This is Stahl firing, blocked by the stick of Boychuk and clear. Stahl back to play it. Islanders change. Girardi flicks it in, and the Rangers will change as well.
Looks like the rest has helped Donnie Boychuk. Got some real good jump. He's had his stick in the shooting lane a number of times.
Letty with speed. Nick Letty tried to set up Tavares. Was flicked away by the stick of Klein. Kept alive now by Bailey to Tavares. Tavares turns on Klein. Picked up by Miller. Tavares squeezed in between those two. Bobrovsky joined the party, but it's the Rangers emerging. And McDonough lugs it into the Islanders zone. Left it at the line. Hit by Boychuk. And here's a lead for Grabowski. Quick shot. Save Lundqvist. Now Grabowski. Tavares. Tangled up with Hayes, who wins the puck. And big Kevin Hayes. Picked up in center. Islanders angled neatly to prevent a Hayes rush. But he finds St. Louis along the near boards. Hits the trailer. Boyle. Picked up effectively by Bailey. And Grabowski gives it away to Hayes, but Grabowski gets it back and lifts it out of the zone. Isinger not. The Islanders needed to get it out of there as the Rangers were beginning to apply some pressure, and it is an icing that'll break the faceoff back into the Islander zone.
Michael Grabowski, well, first, it's a good play by Johnny Boychuk as he rides off McDonough. That creates an odd man situation, and with Tavares having the puck and the speed of Grabowski, quick wrist shot, and Lundqvist has good position at the top of his crease. Islanders going to work down low, and the Islanders are going to call timeout as Tavares' line has been out a little while. Wanting to maintain that 2-0 lead, and it's a good call. You don't always have to call your 2-0 when you're down 2-0. Use your timeout. Use it to maintain your 2-0 lead.
Thinking like that can win you awards. Our trivia question brought to you by Cadillac asks, who are the two players, the only two, who have won both the Masterton and Lady Bing trophies? My partner is one of them.
Absolutely. And Johnny Rattell, the New York Rangers.
Great sentiment.
Yeah, I love that uniform on the right. And that guy there was what a gentleman, John Rattell. I had a chance to get to know him when I was coaching the Boston Bruins. He was my quasi-assistant coach. Terrific guy.
A lot of people called Rattell a poor man's Jean Beliveau back in the day. Not that this youngster would remember any of that. But he's having fun anyway.
Yeah, could be a potential John Tavares or a potential Butch Goring. Who knows? Didn't see what number he had on, but and that man there has had a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful career. You know that guy, Marty St. Louis, number 26. My mother sits at home and wears his jersey. What's wrong with that woman?
Really?
Marty, she loves Marty St. Louis. She thinks he's just wonderful. So I can't argue that he's not a great hockey player.
Hold on. is Mama Goring sitting at home in Winnipeg wearing a Ranger jersey watching this game? McDonough's drive goes
wearing
by.
Wearing the Marty St. Louis jersey.
Put out in front. St. Louis drops it for Stepan. Another save by Halak. Brider. Look, a run there. That's straight. He lost his lid in the process.
And the guys got to keep their heads down there. This is, you know, when they're pushing and the shoving, you get a little emotions going on. Got to stay in control, Howie.
Mrs. Goring has explaining to do. 13:58 left in the third.
Coliseum, Ed Mangano, Nassau County executive, joining me at the Coliseum in the third period. Islanders up 2-0. I know you're excited to be here for this Rangers game. How awesome has it been, the resurgence of the team in this final year at the Coliseum?
This is great for the people in Nassau County, the fans. When I went to college, every single year I was in college, they won a Stanley Cup. So it's great to be here. It's great. The excitement's back. And we're looking to cheer them on for another Stanley Cup.
I know with the weather, the fans were really hoping they were going to be able to get to the game. So thank you to all the people of the county that were able to clear the roads and help with that. When the team does move to Brooklyn next year, how will they stay connected to Long Island?
Well, clearly under the construction phase here, they'll be able to stay connected through their great community events and the community outreach. We've already spoke to the Islands about that. They're going to come back to an exhibition game during the construction season here. So we're going to keep our connection with our hometown team.
All right. Do you want to do the tradition now? Do you want to do the yes, yes, yes?
Yes, yes, yes.
All right. Go ahead, guys. Take it away.
And maybe some chants downstairs of stay, stay, stay. But it is 3-0 as Ryan Strome has chipped home the third Islander goal of the game.
Yeah, and interesting enough, that's a nice flip-out play by DeHaan. That's a set breakout play off a face-off win by the Islanders. Stromer's trying to go across, and it goes off the stick of McDonough. He's got his head up. He's trying to make the pass, but McDonough gets a stick on it. Lundqvist has to go from left to right to play Franz Nielsen. And the Islanders get a bit of a lucky break, but you know, you go back even further, Howie, as Franz Nielsen got thrown out of the faceoff, so right-handed Ryan Strome took the draw, and he won it, and that started the playoff.
I can't help but think if Ed Mangano had gone for his masters, he might have had two more rings.
Left school a little too early.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know who to blame now.
He gets blamed for enough. It's all right. Leave him alone. Letterbuck down the boards. Well, that's where all county executives and governors and mayor, they all get blamed for everything, so
part of the deal, I guess.
Right or not, part of the fun. And now, Ryan Strome has made it 3-0 for Nielsen and DeHaan at 6-12. Ninth of the year for young Mr. Strome.
Young Mr. Strome leads the Islanders in the plus-minus category. He's a plus 18 and was added to that total tonight.
Lundqvist is going to have to hold on.
Well, the fans are obviously, you can hear them pretty excited about their club. That's just a flip play. Franz is able to get it to Ryan Strome. You can see the frustration on Lundqvist there as his reaction. He tries to go across again to prevent that goal mouth play by Franz Nielsen. And Ryan Strome, let me correct myself, he was a plus 16, he's now a plus 17, but he still leads the team.
Well, they're chanting Henrik derisively at Henrik Lundqvist. Alvin DeHaan has picked up three helpers. He's been in on all of the Islander goals.
And a nice plus three, Howie, and that's always important.
And the Islanders now, let's see, 6-3, 6-12. Outscore the Rangers 12-3 so far in two and a little more than two-thirds games so far this season.
Now the most important thing for the Islanders right now again is to manage the puck as well as manage the time.
Stealing, it's not a bad idea. Bailey does. Tavares shoots wide.
What a tremendous opportunity there for John Tavares. He'll be looking at that one a little bit later in his sleep.
Haglin had one blocked. Comes through to Boyle. Across to Hunwick, and he shot it wide. Boyle has a little trouble, needs to reach back, but he controls the puck. Round now to Haglin. Fast in the corner. Haglin chased by Tavares. Right through the slot, picked up by Bailey. Grabowski to Tavares. He's got room on the right, but he's by himself with the Islanders changing. Trying to fight through Hunwick, and Fast comes up with a puck.
Now late in the shift, Tavares would have been a little bit better served to chip it in behind and change.
Hayes winds it in. Halak wheels it around. Right to JT Miller of the Rangers, who has it picked up off his stick by Strom. And now Letty on the rush. Letty around to the far side. Boychuk to Letty. Throws one to the net. That's blockered aside by Lundqvist. And the Islander fans, clearly in the majority tonight, are being heard now louder and more consistently than at any time during the game.
And with good reason.
10:36 remaining in the third. Nice play by Letty, and here's a lead. A breakaway from Martin, but he lost the handle. And Matt Martin in pursuit of his second of the night.
Oh, he had a breakaway coming in with a change on the bench.
Now Kreider. Round to the far side. Clutterbuck in on Stepan.
The Rangers have no choice but to take chances now to really press the issue. Islanders will have to move the puck in a hurry in their own zone.
Stepan away from Cizikas. The side of the net looking for St. Louis. Islander fans continue to taunt Henrik Lundqvist, who has not had an answer for the Islanders this season.
Well, for that matter, his team hasn't had much of an answer either.
Zuccarello tried to play it across. It popped up. Islanders don't clear, though. Zuccarello's got it back. Now to Brassard. Eric Brassard wheeling back to the line. Gave it away to Grabner. And Grabner just backhands it in. A bouncer that's chased by Nelson. Grabner goes after Brassard and whips it up the left wing to Rick Nash. 9:22 to go in the third. 3-0 Islanders. Nash trying to get away from Grabner. Drops it off to McDonough. Moore, one-timer. That's deflected away into the corner.
Two Islander defense in front of the net for the deflection and the block shot.
Moore plays it down the boards to Nash. Cross to McDonough. Wrist shot. Halak's got that. Absorbs another little whack by Girardi. Hickey immediately takes exception to that. And there's no further play. Islander fans having a party with 8:56 left in the third. Tonight on MSG, it's the unforgettable tale of a dream that became a lie. I guess if the Islanders win this and continue along their way, you'll be in a good enough mood to enjoy the inside story of John Spano and the Islanders and look back at that debacle. ESPN Films presents 30 for 30, Big Shot, tonight at 10:30 on MSG. I remember Butch not knowing, of course, that Mr. Spano did not have, well, he didn't have enough money to run a hockey team anyway. We were in Tampa, and I asked him even then, as Stahl takes a shot wide, Karams to Boyle, save made. I said, you making any progress on a new building? And he looked at me and he said, if I have to pay for it myself, I'll pay for it myself. Nope. Oh, boy. Kind of an illegal Walter Mitty, I guess.
He did have a banquet for us ex-Islanders, so that was not all bad.
Who paid for you?
Not me.
Grabowski now to center. Grabowski in over the line. Look for Bailey. It was behind him.
Not a good play. You're up 3-0 again. Puck management, Howie. You don't need any more goals. You don't have a good, solid play. You chip the puck in behind the net. It's an area the Islanders have had a lot of opportunities, need to continue to get better. They've made progress, but obviously not perfect yet.
Three-goal lead, 8 minutes to play. Tavares around. Tavares holding. Added to Hahn with three assists. Fires one off the inboard.
And a good play by Tavares. Again, take the puck to the outside, protect it, and then make a smart play. And that's the difference between him and Grabowski on those two rushes.
Well, at this stage of the game with the Islanders up three, it's clearly safe play time of the night, isn't it?
It absolutely. You don't throw the puck anywhere in the slot area unless you're 100% sure. You chip it in behind and you make them go to work.
Boychuk misses it. Stepan recovers. Checked by Anders Lee. Girardi at the line. Tries a pass to McDonough. Then Boychuk interrupted. And now McDonough feeds the slot. St. Louis didn't get much on that. Has another chance. Moves it to Stepan. And he fired it wide. 7-10. Remaining in the third. Strome, who has the 3-0 goal, around to the far side. And Lee chips it out. The referee forced right, at least the linesman anyway, right to the Islander bench. Well, coming up, the Foxwoods Final Five. Foxwoods, excitement every day.
Well, you can see the Islanders as you watch them play in their defensive zone and trying to sort it out when there's a little bit of Ranger pressure and they're talking to one another and communication is important. Well, the Islanders, when they score three or more, pretty strong. When the Rangers give up more than two, now they're in a whole bunch of problems there. So they've given up three. That's one more than when they're really successful, Howie. So it's looking good. And Alain Vigneault has got to start to wonder, you know, what he needs to do to be a little more competitive with his team. Yes, they had a pretty good push in the second period, but at the end of the day, they're down 3-0.
And you might have picked up the chant in the background. Islander fans jubilantly chanting, "You can't beat us." And that would appear to certainly be statistically provable to this point. 6:44 to go in the third. There's the chant again.
That was a chant that was very prevalent years ago when he was, the shoe was on the other foot.
Hunwick dancing in the corner with pressure applied by Hamonic. Now Klein for Brassard. Out to Zuccarello. He shoots. Halak the save. Rebound Brassard. Halak scrambling. Gets the whistle. And there's no further play. More mild hostilities develop, but Yaroslav Halak has been downright brilliant in this game.
Absolutely, and you can just see how competitive he is and how aggressive he remains following the puck. And again, striving to get back towards the shooting area, if you will. Nash is there, a couple of opportunities, but you can just see the reaction of Halak has been so good, so quick. Even on deflections, he gets himself up and back into position.
Well, it's the longest the Islanders have gone consecutively without allowing a goal to the Rangers. Boyle chased along the line by Lee. That frees the puck. Strome connects with Lee. Working against Staal. Takes Lee out hard and legally. Good play by Mark Staal. And back for the Islanders is straight. Hickey. Get away from the oncoming St. Louis, and the Islanders clear out again.
A little chip and chase for the Islanders. Nice, easy clear by Thomas Hickey. Look for the Islanders to make quick changes, stay fresh out there.
5:44 remaining in the third. St. Louis offside as they reach the Islander blue line. So 5:38 remaining in the third. It's the Islander fans having all the fun. Well, the Islanders with that 3-0 lead with 5:38 to go in the third, so there could be, if things hold up, plenty of happy reaction from the Islanders and Coach Capuano. You'll hear it after the game, plus highlights and analysis, all on the Mazda Islanders post-game show. Butch will be along with Geico Extra to add his perspective. A little extra face time for Mr. E equals MC2.
I might bring a little more physics to the table, perhaps.
That would be great. Professor Goring.
I was going to say that was offside.
You realize the possibilities?
Yes, they're endless.
Do you know what the internet is going to do to this?
I know. I put myself out there and I'll get slammed.
No, it's all good. I've seen some of the artwork.
Yes.
It's not exactly been the kind of artistic beauty from a Ranger perspective that Alain Vigneault is hoping for. First game for the Rangers out of the break, but you know, even though the Rangers have outshot the Islanders 40-32, and a lot of the story tonight is Yaroslav Halak, there have been times when, you know, the Rangers for spells have been overwhelmed by the Islanders.
Particularly in the first period, I thought the Islanders did what they needed to do, establish their presence and get a quick early lead. Rangers are very much a first period club. One of the leaders in the National Hockey League, tied with the Islanders, I believe, for third with 45 goals.
McDonough had done just enough interference legally there to perfect an Islander rush. It'll be a face-off now with exactly 5 minutes remaining in the third period.
Well, this first line that Jack Capuano has put together, because of Kyle Oposo's injury, has played very, very well tonight. They've been solid through the entire game. A couple of turnovers in the third period, but they're a little bit high risk, and they bring a little offense to the table, obviously.
And now the Rangers break to center. Hayes throws it in. Last check by Letty. Rangers keep it alive. Down the boards comes Klein. Slips it back to the blue line to Miller, but he mishandles the puck. And so Grabner sends Nelson ahead. Grabner in the slot. Nelson, use it down low. Grabner taken down by Tanner Glass, and there'll be a penalty to Glass.
Oh, no doubt about it.
Drive by Letty is blocked. Delayed penalty. Out of the net comes Halak. Rangers take possession, and the Islanders leading by 3-4, 25 to go in the third. We'll go to the power play, and frankly, looking at that play just with a naked eye, from an Islander perspective, you're just glad Michael Grabner's okay.
Yeah, because it's a little bit of a dangerous play. Glass has a stick down on the ice, as you can see him trying to check. And he goes in pretty hard. Michael gets his feet out from under him, though, and goes in skate first. Might have to get his skates sharpened again, but able to protect himself. You know, you're going a little sideways, Howie, you can get twisted around a little bit. So as a former player, that's what you try to do, is kick your feet out, take the blunt with your skate.
So the Islanders power play is brought to you by the New York Lottery. Hey, you never know. Tavares, and they won a draw that they're going to say was a false faceoff.
I haven't seen them make that call for a long, long time. I'll tell you what, they give everybody an awful lot of latitude on these faceoffs.
I'd say Tavares, I guess, was a little too frisky.
Now Ryan Strome's on the strong side anyway as a right-hander.
Now from the draw, Strome sweeps it back to Nielsen. Tavares to Boychuk, lines it up. He shoots, went wide on the short side.
It looked like there was a bit of an opening on that short side also.
And now Haglin. Of course, the Rangers cannot afford to sit back and just try to kill the penalty. They need to take some chances here, which could result in real odd man situations for the Islanders on this power play, which has a minute 34 remaining.
Jack Capuano continues to use his power play, per se, with four forwards and 1D.
Ups that all the way down, or at least into the Islanders zone. Nielsen battles with Nash. And then Nash is going to go for taking Nielsen down.
Yeah,
here.
Slashing penalty. Now a little frustration on the part of the New York Rangers. Tanner Glass with a trip, and now Rick Nash, who has been very good at killing penalties. Well, watch, there's the two-hander right there as he comes down on the stick. I don't think he hit Franz on the hands at all, but you can't slash the stick, the body, anything at all. Gotta play a little more tame game these days. The Islanders have an opportunity to salt this game away with a 5-on-3. And Alain Vigneault, you're talking about physics. Well, he's gonna have to go back to the chalkboard and figure this all out.
Well, you can always help if you like. You're the new professor. And you're also watching the Foxwoods Final Five. Foxwoods, excitement every day. Visit Foxwoods.com now. Two-man advantage for the Islanders for minute 14. Tavares for Strome in the corner. Tavares to Lee in front. Flicked away by Lundqvist. Just barely got a piece of it. Lee behind the net. The Islanders have everything going for them here. The clock, the lead, and the 5-on-3 advantage. Tavares shoots, he scores! Power play goal, 4-0 Islanders. And they'll still have a power play.
Tavares has got that sharp eye. You can always tell if you're starting to cheat as a goaltender a little bit. The Islanders patiently move the puck around. Again, it starts with a faceoff win, and Tavares has been really good tonight. All over the ice on his faceoffs, on his tenacity, his puck retrieval. I mean, he has just been a shark out there. The Islanders take their time on the power play once they get control, but Tavares is going to look, and he just sees something there. He's a gifted goal scorer, takes a quick look and says, I only need a small little hole to get it into the back of the net.
And did he ever. So John Tavares with his 22nd. Islanders still with a minute 18 of power play time. Just under 3 minutes remaining in the third period. All Islanders now, 4-0. 16:47, the time of the Tavares goal.
This is the fourth line that's on the ice, and they don't see a whole lot of power play. Not accustomed to spreading themselves out. They want to dump it in the corner and go to work. Power play, you don't want it in the corner. You want it out near the blue line and move it around a little bit, drive to the net. So this is a little bit different for them, but good for Jack Capuano to give these guys an opportunity and not throw any salt on the wound. He doesn't need any more goals. He recognizes it and doesn't want to pile it on. So good for Jack Capuano on both fronts.
Kamenik and Boychuk picked up the assists on the 5-on-3 goal. Islanders still with 50 seconds Power play time to go. Have it completely under control here with 2:27 to go in the third period. Push back to the line to Letty. Letty lets go a drive. I believe that hit Kevin Klein, the Rangers, before it's cleared all the way down by Hatlin. And Martin. And Stahl. Continue to shove. And Glass gets involved. Now it's Glass and Martin.
Now Stahl and pushing up on. Now the two of them may or may not go. The linesman, Matty, really doesn't need to fight here.
Well, he's ready to.
Glass. Yeah, he's not going to back away. There's no doubt about it. But Martin doesn't need to fight here. Tanner Glass is also a tough guy. Knows him very, very well. Nothing to prove. Wait till the next game. Let him fester a little bit. But it was between Stahl and Martin originally. Matt Martin wasn't going to back away. Took him out heavily. Good clean check. Stahl didn't like it. Pushed back a couple of times. Didn't want to fight. I don't blame him. And then Tanner Glass tried to come to the rescue of his teammate Stahl. I'm happy that Matty's going off the ice now with no fight. He's had a big, strong game. Nothing to prove.
And that next game between the Rangers and Islanders will be here 20 days from today, the 16th of February.
And you can see how that starts. A good solid check. And now they're just talking to one another. Dahl decides to give a little push. And now he's got to deal with Matty's got to deal. It's a 2-on-1. Now it's a 3-on-1. The old face rub by Tanner Glass, the rake. And that probably bothers Matty more than anything else. But it doesn't matter. The Islanders are going to win this game. They played very, very well. They've got great goaltending. They've scored some nice goals. It's been a great pace game. Lots of intensity on here. The fans have been entertained. And let's have this game end on a very positive note. No need to sort of string it along, if you will, Howie.
Of course, for Halak, he just wants to maintain that focus that he's had with 2:05 remaining here in the third period. And whatever the penalty calls, Jack Capuano bemused, but in the end, he clenched those fists in celebratory fashion, although he still can't understand how this has been adjudicated the way it's been.
Now they're trying to figure it all out. And now that those two guys pretty much tell the story.
Well, if there was any question on the part of any fans around the National Hockey League about whether or not this Islander team is in fact for real, and it gets asked every so often, various mileposts to the season, and here after a week off for the All-Star break, the question comes up again. I heard it in a radio interview I did on our Mets flagship station, WOR, earlier today, and was asked, well, what about these Islanders? Can they keep this up? Are they real? Is this genuine? Well, it's a short answer. Yes. Now, what's the call on Tavares? I'm hearing a bench minor for the Islanders.
Well, it was a bench minor, or else, he's sitting in for the 2 minutes for Matt Martin, possibly. I don't know what, we haven't heard the calls yet. Jack Capuano was not happy. He wanted to know why team was shorthanded on an exchange. And as I said, it was Martin against Stahl, and then Klein, and then Tanner Glass.
So 4-on-4 for 17 seconds. Then the Rangers will have a power play. So we're under 2 minutes to go in the third now. 10 seconds left on the penalty to Nash. Hamannik against Hayes. Hamannik keeps the heat on. That is Hamannik in a great battle with Kevin Hayes. Nash is out of the box. Minute 37 left on the clock. 5 seconds fewer on the Islander penalty. Here's Klein to Hunwick. Hunwick put it out in front. Broken up. And Ryan Strome will skate it out. He's got Nielsen with him. Strome keeps going. Now he pulls up, hits the trailer to Hahn, and he shoots one off the arm of Lundqvist.
Yeah, what a great play by Ryan Strome, recognizing that Franz Nielsen was going to get caught. Just slowed the pace down and hit to Hahn coming in late. Just real heads-up play by Ryan Strome.
And it's 7 remain in the third, and that's going to be as good as an Islander clear. And we are down to the final minute as Lundqvist comes way out to handle it. Rangers on the power play, but this one is in the Islanders' back pocket with a 4-0 lead. Boyle played it down low, right out in front. Miller couldn't hold on to it. And it's cleared.
by Letty. So the Islanders about to make it 3 out of 3 against the Rangers this year. And again, we mentioned the Islanders had played 2 more games than the Rangers coming into this one. That's still the case, but this will now open up a 7-point lead for the Islanders over the third-place Rangers. Pittsburgh, by the way, won their game tonight as that puck leaves play. Penguins defeated the Winnipeg Jets 5-3, so the Islanders will stay 3 points ahead of second-place Pittsburgh in the Metropolitan Division. And the Rangers continue to hear the chant of "You can't beat us," which until further notice is not so much a chant as it is factual.
Well, the Islanders, for me, have learned some lessons along the way, and they're playing a much better defensive game, more solid. Talked about the block shots, Howie, and put themselves in position.
Dominic Moore trying to squeeze one through the check of straight. Can't do it. Recovered by Fast in front. Hatlin, he scores. He just did push it past Halak on the short side to break the shutout. And with 8.1 seconds remaining, the Rangers on the board. The Islander lead is 4-1, and you could see how disappointed Halak is that he will not close out his second consecutive shutout against the Rangers.
And Halak gets an opportunity. Dominic Moore doesn't get much of a shot. It drops down on Brian Straight. And there's just not a whole lot left as Halak gets a part of it on the original save and tries to go across. And you're right, he's a little ticked off, and he has reason to be. Only 8 seconds left, but he's played a tremendous game. And for the moment, he'll be upset, but after that, he'll be a fairly happy guy as he's played a real, real good game. I don't think there's really anything he could have done with that. He stopped the original shot. It was just a bad break as Brian Straight had the puck caught up in his paraphernalia and then couldn't quite find the end of it.
But the end of it, meaning the game, has come. And the Islanders could celebrate a 4-1 win over the New York Rangers. Islanders 3-0 against the Rangers this year. Yaroslav Halak somehow has the expression beneath the mask, or so it would appear, of mild disappointment. That will wear off, I would imagine, within seconds. But you see that domination of the Rangers, of the Islanders in the division this year, 16-2. Including 9 straight wins within the division. They are 10-0 in the division here at home. 3-point night for DeHaan.
Yeah, DeHaan had a real strong night, and he's mentioned how he 3 points, a plus three. And there's Tavares leading his group in the yes, yes, yes chant. And they're really relishing into this newfound cheer, I guess, for lack of a better term, and the excitement and the fun that the fans are having with this game. But you're right, I mean, it's been impressive. And you know, we listened to Jack Capuano at the start of the season, and one of the things that he talked about being better was winning at home. And true to his words, his team have been much, much better. They played a very exciting brand of hockey, but they played, for me, with just a whole lot of energy. I mean, they just are out skating the oppositions for the most part.
17-4 are the Islanders in this building this year. Club record for wins in the first 21 home games has been matched by the Islanders. And yeah, there are ways to win games that might not have existed during the dynasty years. But round 3 does go to the Islanders. So did round 1 and 2.
It's been 3 straight knockouts, really, if you will, for the Islanders, and they've been the better team. I thought the Rangers, though, did have a pretty good push in the second.
Our stars of the game are sponsored by your Tri-State Land Rover dealers. Matt Martin is the third star of the game. I guess a lot.
The second star.
If he's not the first, would be the second. Yeah, he's going to be the second. And that means that John Tavares will be the star of the game. And Shannon's waiting for him down on the ice as JT provides a souvenir. For all the talk about the All-Star game, I would imagine this one was far more satisfying. Shannon?
John, a pretty fantastic way to cap off an awesome weekend for you in Columbus at the All-Star game. What is it about the Rangers and playing them that brings out the best in this Islanders team?
I mean, you can just feel the atmosphere tonight, the passion from both teams, but certainly our fans have been tremendous. You can feel it in the building, and a lot of fun to play against. These are the games that you want to win.
How important is it to kick off the second part of the season with a big win over a rival?
Yeah, it's nice after a few days. Nice to have a big game like this to come back to, and certainly with how tight the standings are, we know how important these wins are.
All right, thanks so much for your time, John. Congratulations on the win.
Thank you. Thanks, everybody.
Guys, back up to you.
All right, Shannon. So for some who might have wondered, would it be worth the effort to fight through the elements and whatever the conditions of the roads in their neighborhoods might have been to come out here tonight? At least we know the Islander fans among those people have been rewarded as they have defeated the New York Rangers 4-1. Yes, 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 say the Islanders in response to their fans. We'll sum it all up. The Mazda Islanders postgame is coming up right after this.